I'm back on Dartmoor again, and I've just walked up from Chagford.
So yeah, I'm just going to enjoy this view, to be honest with you. I could sit and stare at this all day long.
But I've got a few interesting things coming up along this route, so I'm quite looking forward to them. But I am tired. It's heavy going. So yeah, that was the route across those stones. Unfortunately, one of them was quite slippery and I slipped. Hi there. So yeah, I'm back on Dartmoor again, and I've just walked up from Chagford. I'm heading out towards Sittaford Tor, where I've camped before when I went to Postbridge. But I'll be heading, instead of heading south from Sittaford tomorrow, I'll be heading west towards, well, we'll see. I'm not making any bold claims. Things can change, as I've discovered quite a few times in my last videos. So I'm going to head up towards Sittaford now. It's a beautiful day. It's quite windy. I hope you can hear me. I'm facing away from the wind with this new microphone, so fingers crossed we've got better audio than last time. I make no promises, but I'm going to crack on now, so let's go walking Devon. You soon get to see how much history is on Dartmoor as I come across this Bronze Age settlement. The remains of the hut circles and field boundaries are still remaining to this day. So it's suddenly got a bit boggy around here. So lucky that it's been dry for such a while, otherwise this would be very difficult, but you've got to watch your step so careful here, because you can find yourself shin deep in no time at all. Tread on the tussocks where you can. But yeah, it's all very squelchy. Now you see this bit here. This is obviously bog. I need to go around it. Just got to be careful, that's all. Take your time. The path is just up there. I might be able to get through here. There we go. Back on track. It is important for me to make good time on this first leg of my trip and reach Sittaford Tor if I'm to achieve my goal of crossing Dartmoor. Bogs and streams slow my progress, but my thoughts turn to enjoying a nice cup of coffee once I set up camp. So I made it to Sittaford Tor, all in good time. It's 6:30. I've got plenty of time to enjoy this lovely view of Bellevue Forest through there. That's Postbridge down there. Let's set up tent. And I'm really looking forward to that cup of coffee. Yeah, let's enjoy the camp and hopefully enjoy a nice walk tomorrow. Oh, good morning. Glad I got a midge net. Still getting through a little bit though, but it's keeping most of them off me. Yeah, it's a beautiful day. I slept okay-ish. I couldn't get to sleep very easily, to be honest with you, but once I did, that was it. I was out for the count. There's absolutely no dew today, so I'm just going to pack the tent up and head on.
and head on east. I feel good today. I'm ready to go. So, yeah.
Let's crack on.
I'm glad I'm doing this route today. I've been meaning to do it for a long time. You see, Northern Dartmoor, it's the army come up here and do live firing. So it's out of bounds for certain periods. There is a live firing times that they publish on the government website, which you need to check and see where the zones are. But during August, which is what it is at the moment, they don't do any firing, so it's perfectly safe to come up along here, as long as you don't stump any ordnance and fiddle with it. And once we move into September, and if I'm still coming up here, then I'll just start exploring Southern Dartmoor, because they don't do any firing down there on Southern Dartmoor. So we can have a good explore around there in the future. But I've got a few interesting things coming up along this route, so I'm quite looking forward to them. This is a nice surprise. Lovely waterfall. Beautiful scene. I've got to get across this though. But first, I think I'll get a photo. I think that looks really nice.
So far, my feet have been wet pretty much every time I've been on the moors. Luckily, this was easier to cross than I'd anticipated, and I was able to continue with just damp feet. So I'll put a link in the description of the Ordnance Survey route that I'm taking on this trip. But I wouldn't necessarily recommend it, to be honest with you, because I'm walking along here and it's quite a long way. And yeah, can you see where the path is? I can just about make it out. So yeah, I wouldn't necessarily recommend this, but I'm going to crack on with it anyway, because it's kind of fun. So if you like this kind of challenge, then yeah, go for it.
So just to the south of this route is Wisman's Wood. So I thought I'd pop in there. It's a mile down there and obviously a mile to get back onto my route. So it's adding to my overall distance today. But as I'm passing, I think it's worth going down. So let's crack on and have a look.
Wisman's Woods is an ancient and captivating woodland. Its unique appearance features twisted and moss-covered oak trees, creating a magical atmosphere. The wood's distinctive look is a result of harsh weather conditions and centuries of growth. Wisman's Wood is protected due to its fragile ecosystem and is a site of special scientific interest. Visitors are encouraged to follow guidelines to preserve its beauty and charm by remaining at the edge of the woods. This is the source of the Devonport Leat. It was built in the 1790s and originally took water 27 miles to Plymouth Dock, now called Devonport.
I've got my hood up because I've been out in the sun all day to get a bit of sun protection. Everything that I wear is SPF 50, so I don't get burnt. There's no shelter on the moors, so it's quite easy to get burnt. But I am absolutely loving this. It's a beautiful day. There's some amazing views here. I'm actually in the danger area now, but obviously there's no firing. I've decided to head towards Lydford. That's going to be my exit of the moor, so I will have gone right across. I think it's about 9 miles to Lydford. I'm going to do another 4, I think, and then set up my tent, and then that means that I've just got a 5 mile walk into Lydford in the morning. But I'm just going to relax. I've got plenty of time to make up these 4 miles, so I'm just going to enjoy it.
The isolation of the moors. Its unique beauty and harsh environment keeps making me want to return and relive that feeling of freedom to roam with everything you need on your back. I wouldn't change a thing.
Yeah, I'm going to stop filming now and just find somewhere to camp in the next, mile and a half I think I've got. But I am tired. It's heavy going, all this boggy ground with the weight on the back as well. But yeah, let's crack on. I think I'm going to set my tent up here. I'm just over 5 miles away from Lydford, so that gives me a relatively short walk tomorrow. So I've got my tent set up. I'm not expecting visitors, so I haven't tidied up. But that's my view for this evening. It's not bad. So yeah, it's 6 o'clock now. I'm just going to relax now and enjoy the evening. But I am tired. I think another contributing factor to the tiredness was it was very warm today. So yeah, I'm just going to enjoy this view, to be honest with you. I could sit and stare at this all day long. In fact, that's probably what I'm going to do. Better than telly. Well, good morning. I've already packed up, had a bit of rain throughout the night, not particularly heavy. I kept nice and dry. There's a few damp patches in the tent, but only damp, not wet. So yeah, I'm just going to head into Lydford today. And it's now 20 past nine. So it's still quite early. I don't know how long it's going to take me to get in or what the route is like. So let's crack on.
Well, I've nearly done it. After several attempts, I have my goal of hiking from the eastern edge to the western edge of Dartmoor in sight. I ended up walking in total nearly 24 miles across some quite difficult terrain, and I'm really happy to have nearly achieved my goal. So yeah, that was the route across those stones. Unfortunately, one of them was quite slippery and I slipped and put one leg in. And so I decided to just wade through, basically. And yeah, so I'm wet up to the knees. But that's okay. It's not cold. And hopefully the trousers will dry out quite quickly. I'll just leave the boots as they are. Once I get into Lydford, if the boots are dried out a little bit, I can change my socks. I've got a clean pair. I thought something like that might happen, so I did save a pair of socks. But let's crack on.
So I really hope you enjoy coming along with me on this trip. I've still got a couple of miles to go into Lydford. I'm going to carry on with this video. But if you enjoyed this, please pop down and give it a like. And leave me a comment. You know, what was your favourite part of this trip? It might even still be coming up. But Lydford's not going to come to me. I've got to get to Lydford. So best crack on. I made it to Lydford. I'm really pleased with myself, actually. It's quite a challenge going across Dartmoor like that. It's had its ups and downs. So anyway, I really hope you enjoy coming along with me. So until next time, take care.